Welcome to the Scholars Learning Classes. In this video, we will be studying about the tools of financial analysis. What are the different tools that we have? Number one, we have is comparative statement. Now, when the financial statement figures for two or more years are placed side by side to facilitate comparison, then these are called comparative financial statement. Let's suppose you are given the balance sheet and you are given the current year figures and the previous year figures. So you can just find out the increase decrease or the increase decrease percentage out of it and calculate the comparative statement. So basically this is done when you are given the two or more year figures. Second is your common size statement. Now in these statements, various figures are converted into percentages to some base, common base. Now if I talk about in profit and loss statement, revenue from operations figure is taken at 100 and all other figures are expressed as the percentage of revenue operations. So we'll understand this better when we will be doing the practical of common size statement. So what we'll do is we'll add all the values in the particular field. Right, then we will compare, we'll make the common size statement using that value as the base figure. Third comes your trend analysis. Now it is one of the most useful form of horizontal analysis in making comparative study of the financial statements for a number of years. For calculating trend percentages, any year is selected as a base year. You will select any of the year as base year and you will take all the values in terms of base year and you will calculate the percentage out of it. So in this you can find out the trend increase and decrease in the various values. Then comes your fourth and most major and most important, that is accounting ratios. See, accounting ratios are your vertical analysis, which means only figure of current year is given and you need to calculate the ratios. Now what are accounting ratio? Ratio is simply one number expressed in relationship with other, and a study of relationship between various items or group of items is known as ratio analysis. We will be doing ratio analysis in the coming chapter, full-fledged ratio analysis that we have, and we surely get one long question out of this ratios. So we have different kind of ratio, your liquidity ratio, solvency ratio, profitability ratio. So all these ratio, with the calculation of these ratios, you analyze what is the current status of your organization. Then comes your cash flow statement. Cash flow statement. Now see, your cash flow statement is basically, it gives you the inflows and outflows of the cash and cash equivalents during a particular period and analyze the reasons for change in the balance of cash, that why the cash in the starting was this and at the end of the year is this. So what are the cash transactions that have taken place in the whole of the year? So you can make cash flow statement. It is up to you. You want to make on monthly basis, daily basis, or you want to make quarterly basis. That totally depends upon the company. Then comes your fund flow statements. Now your fund flow statement is designed to show the changes in the assets, liabilities and capital of the firm between the dates of two balance sheets. Now let's suppose my previous balance sheet and current balance sheet will take all the balances of assets, liabilities and capital, how they have been changed, what are the reason behind it. We'll make three types of accounts in this. Although fund flow statement is not there in your syllabus, so you might be learning this fund flow statement in your graduation or post graduation, but till now it is if the cash flow tells about the inflow and outflow of the cash, whereas fund flow statements tell you about the inflow and outflow of the funds. So funds are not only the cash, funds are also the investments that you make or the investment that is going out. So asset, liabilities and capital, everything you consider in fund flow statements. Seventh comes your break-even analysis. right? So break even point is the point where there is total costs are exactly equal to total revenue. So where there is no profit, no loss situation is your break even point analysis. So again, this analysis is very important for your organization. I hope you like our video. Please download our College Learning app and enjoy the learning experience with us.